Nature is beautiful, believe it or not. Nature is our source. Love it or hate it, nature waters and feeds us. God gave us nature. We can't live without it. Nature makes us. These beautiful verses of Kerry King reminds us the relationship of mankind with nature. Mankind and nature are inseparably joined, and we cannot move alone. With this concept in mind, in 1987, Harlem Brundtland coined the term sustainable development, which means environment-friendly development. It shows guidelines and initiatives to grow with nature, like efficient use of pollution-free energy, increasing the recycling process to reuse waste, developing only products such as 100% recycled. In recent decades, humans have made unprecedented changes to meet the growing demands of food, water, fiber, and energy with the help of science and technology. But first, to protect God's inner nature. As a result, we have surmounted many problems like pollution, water scarcity, global warming, hazardous waste, and resource depletion. These human-created crises, when the negative roles of technology has brought us in a situation of flux and confusion. Now we are at crossroads, distant from nature, like a baby child away from mother. We do not have solution when summer is a super hot or when winter is a super chill. Our natural resources are at peak and our health care is at peril. For instance, Our environment activist Dili Agarwal dies yesterday by an intermittent fast to save River Ganga. A great economist once said, "The world's greatest challenging problem, poverty, is not as a lack of cash, but as a lack of natural resources." Yes, it is true. The people who depend on natural resources are better lived than the people who depend on national resources. Sustainable development, therefore, not about science and technological development, not even human development, but nature resource development. A wise man once said, "Nature performs miracles greater than even raising from the dead." That's why our ancestors have given God that abnormal status to nature. Innumerable miracles are performed day by day, growing grass, flower, and fruit right in front of our eyes. So my dear fellow men, our foremost task in today's world is to develop natural resources. Thank Almighty, even today we have vast sea, hills and mountains, valleys and roads, and the miracle of growing crops. These all will help us attain the lost glory on earth. Undoubtedly, we have the best blood, best brain, new thoughts, and are confident enough to challenge the impossible ideas. In the 17th chapter of St. Luke, it is written, "The kingdom of God is within man, not in one man, but in everyone." It is time for us to unite and time for us to join hands beyond border, religion, and free to develop not only our nation but the whole world. Let us together explore the sun and the stars to tap the energy. Let us together discover the inner pressure in nature. Let us mix brain with soil and produce greater products from agriculture. Let us use the power to create heaven under our feet, with the epic poets Homer and Milton paying to express in their poems. Let us all join hands, and let us all unite to make a better world for every creature. Thank you.
Now let us all like that.
Last one you say.
Let us all join our hands.